stinky and crowded.
And then he probably, because the room is very smelly. Thank you for coming.
He's adorable.
He's because they're your best friend.
I love you, and you're the best baby I ever seen. That myself.
Thank you. Thank you. especially an area of southern Mexico. The Aztecs had many uses for them, including the flowers, actually special types of beans known as bracts rather than being flowers, to make a purple dye for clothes and cosmetics, and the milky white salve was made into a medicine to treat fevers. The poinsettia was made widely known because of a man called Joel Roberts Poinsett. He was the first ambassador from the USA to Mexico in 1825. Poinsett had some greenhouses in his plantations in southern South Carolina, and while visiting the Taco area in 1828, he became very interested in the plants. He immediately sent some of the plants back to South Carolina, where he began growing the plants and sending them to his friends at Botanic Gardens. There is an old Christian legend how the Poinsettias and Christmas came together. It goes like this. There was once a poor Mexican girl named Pepita who had no present to give the baby Jesus at the Christmas Eve services. As Pepita walked to the chapel sadly, her cousin Pedro tried to cheer her up. Pepita, he said, I'm sure that the smallest gift given by someone who loves him will make Jesus happy. Pepita didn't know what she could give, so she picked a small handful of weeds from the roadside and made them into a small bouquet. She felt embarrassed because she could only give the small present to Jesus. As she walked through the chapel to the altar, she remembered what Pedro had said. She said that she began to feel better, knelt down, and put the bouquet at the bottom of the nativity scene. Suddenly, the bouquet of weeds burst into some bright red flowers, and everyone who saw them were sure that they had seen a miracle. From that day on, the bright red flowers were known as the Flores de Noche Buena, or Flowers of the Holy Night. The shape of the poinsettia flowers and leaves are sometimes thought as the symbol of the Star of Bethlehem, which led the wise men to Jesus. The red-colored leaves symbolize the blood of Christ, and the white represents the purity.
Standing in your glory, you are here. Is this the end of the story? The Christmas story is a good news story, but it's a short story. There are 27 books in the New Testament, but only the story is told in only two, Matthew and Luke, two of Jesus' followers and friends. In Matthew, the story is told in two of 28 chapters, and in Luke, it's told in two of 24 chapters. Both Matthew and Luke finish telling the Christmas story with Joseph and Mary and Jesus returning to Nazareth to live. But Christmas is only the beginning of the amazing life of Jesus. Jesus was not only born, as told in this Christmas story, but when he became a man, Jesus willingly died to take away all of our wrongdoings and bringing us closer to God. Then he came back to life 3 days later. Nothing has been the same since the first Christmas. You can find out more about Jesus' life in the Bible and by Bible studies and coming to church here on Sundays, and we invite you to come back if you do not have a church home. Our evening has come to a close. It has been a joy sharing this evening with you, and I want to thank all of our musicians and vocalists because you are all amazing. Celebrations, we pray that the Holy Spirit will shine His light in your hearts and bring focus to all of your Christmas celebrations. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. May God fill your home with His peace and His joy, and the children will sing and wish you a Merry Christmas.
The last word is coming from behind you and above you because I've been videoing tonight's concert. And we're just so glad that you're here. Do we have talent?
Yes.
Do we have talent? All right. I want to make a couple of announcements. First, on the 15th of December, we're hosting a free parents' night out. It's an opportunity for the parents to go out and have a date, go to a movie, do some shopping, and we'll watch and care for your youngsters December 15th from 5 to 8:30 p.m. So just let us know if you want to make an opportunity to use that ministry. The second invitation is to refreshments out here in the hall. Those have been prepared for you, and you know Methodist refreshments are always good. So again, we thank everyone that participated tonight, and I pray that the joy that we experienced tonight can be taken from here into the hustle and bustle of what happens around us at Christmas throughout the community. Keep that joy, keep it alive, and share it everywhere you go, and go with the joy and the peace of Christ. Amen.